हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू नागेश करस बिहार किड्स स्कूल चैनल शोलापुर। आई निकिता टीचर टीचिंग यू सोशल स्टडीज फॉर ग्रेड 3। यस चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? यस, यू ऑल आर फाइन, वेरी गुड। नाउ चिल्ड्रन, इन दिस टुडे सेशन व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू? यस, वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम टेक्स्ट बुक एक्सरसाइज एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम एनरिचमेंट एक्टिविटी। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन व्हाट वी हैव लर्न? यस, वी हैव लर्न अबाउट लेसन नंबर 5, दिल्ली। In this last session, we have seen some question answers and presentation, animation and interactive task. In this today, we are going to continue with the lesson number 5 and we are going to see textbook exercise and enrichment activity. Okay children, understood? Are you ready with your canopy textbook? You have to open your canopy textbook and page number 28, okay? And you are going to take your pencil in your hand, eraser, everything. You have to be ready with your book, pencil and eraser. Okay, let's start with the session. Okay, children? Yes, already we have learned. What you have learned about Delhi? That Delhi is the capital of India. And the main offices of Delhi of India are located in New Delhi. Even we have seen that Delhi has many ancient monuments and that attract tourists from all over the world. And Delhi is very hot in summer and cold in winter. People of all religion and regions of India live and work in Delhi. Yes, already we have learned so many points about Delhi. Okay, now let's see the textbook exercise. Okay children, are you ready with your textbook, canopy textbook, pencil, eraser? If you are not ready now also, I will wait for a minute, then I will start with the session. Okay children, you have to open your page number 29. Okay children, now let's see about exercise, textbook exercise, question number A. Now what they have given in question number A, you have to write T for true. What you are going to write? T for true. Okay? You are going to write T for true and F for false. Yes, children? Let's see number 1. Delhi is the capital of India. Yes, children? Whether the answer is true or false, Delhi is the capital of India. Yes children, come on, give me the answer. Yes children, Delhi is the capital of India. Yes, what will be the correct answer? Yes, give me the answer children. Yes, is it the capital of India? Yes, the answer is what? True. Okay, now what is the spelling of true children? Yes, T-R-U-E, true. Now let's see the next question. Number 2. Delhi is situated on the bank of the river Hugli. Yes, Delhi is situated on the bank of the river Hugli. Yes, is it right? Where the Delhi is situated, on which bank it is situated? Yes, come on children, we have seen in this lesson which bank, where it is located, which bank it is situated on the river, on the bank of the river. Yes, correct, Yamuna. Where is it situated? On the bank of the river Yamuna. Then is it, the answer is true or false? Come on children, already you have came to know what is the correct answer. What is the correct answer? False. Why it is false? Because Delhi is situated, Delhi is situated on the banks of the river Yamuna, not on the river Hugli. Okay, then the answer will be what? False. F-A-L-S-E, false. Now here you have to write the answer. Delhi is the capital of India. The answer is true. T-R-U-E, true. Okay children, understood? Now let's see the number 3. Rajghat is the samadhi of Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhiji. Is it true or false? Rajghat is the samadhi of Mahatma Gandhi. Yes, come on children. Yes. What is the answer? True. Correct. Write the spelling of true. Very good. Now let's see. Haryana is the neighboring state of Delhi. Yes, what is the correct answer, children? Is the Haryana is the neighboring state of the Delhi? Yes, because Haryana is located in the three side. That's why Haryana is the neighboring state of Delhi. Yes, what is the correct answer? True. T-R-U-E. True. Okay, children. Now let's see. Delhi has a moderate climate. Yes, children. Come on, tell me the answer. Delhi has a moderate climate? No. The answer is wrong. Answer, what will be the answer? False. F-A-L-S-E. False. Okay, children. Done with this question. Right side, true or false? Okay. Let's repeat this question again. Once again. Number one, Delhi is the capital of India. Yes, correct. Answer is true. Delhi situated on the banks of the river Hooghly. Yes, Delhi situated on the banks of the river Hooghly. No, where it is situated? It is situated on the bank of river Yamuna. That's where the answer is what? False. Next one, Rajghat is the Samadhi of Gandhiji. Yes, the answer is correct. Haryana is a neighboring state of Delhi. Yes, because it is located on the three different sides. That's why it is the neighboring state of Delhi. That's why the answer is true. Number five, Delhi has a moderate climate. No, it is false. Let's see the next question. That is, fill in the blank. Okay. At the time of Emperor Shahjahan, Delhi was built. Delhi was called. What is this called? After the at the time of Emperor Shahjahan, Delhi was called as. Yes, come on, children. What it was called as? Shahjahanabad. What it was called as? Shahjahanabad. Now, children, already I have told you. I have gave you the homework to read the spelling. Come on, tell me the spelling of Shahjahanabad. Yes, children, what is the spelling of Shahjahanabad? Yes, S-H-A-H. Yes, correct. Come on, next. J-A. Yes, again, H-A-N. A-B-A-D. For that sake only I am telling to read the hard words. Whenever you will read the hard word, you can write the correct spelling. At the time of Emperor Shahjahan, Delhi was called Shahjahanabad. Okay, children. Next question. The beautiful gardens of the Rashtrapati Bhavan are called which garden? Yes, as you know, there is a beautiful garden in Rashtrapati Bhavan. What are they called as? Yes, correct. Mughal garden. What is the spelling of Mughal? Come on, tell me. Yes, M-U. Yes, G-H-A-L. Very good, children. Mughal gardens. G-A-R-D-E-N-S. Very good, children. I hope you all have read the hard words. The Amar, next see number 3, the Amar Jawan Jyoti burns in the memory of dash. Why we have built Amar Jawan Jyoti in the memories of whom? In the memories? Yes, in the memories of, correct, soldier. What is the spelling of soldier? S-O. Yes, children, come on, tell me the spelling of soldier. Yes. Yes, S-O-L-I-D-E-R-S. Correct. What is the spelling of soldier? S-O-L-I-D-E-R-S. Soldiers. The Loo is a hot and dry wind that blows during which season? It is blows. The Loo is a hot and dry wind that blows during. Yes, come on, children. In which season it blows? Yes, already we have discussed. It blows in summer, it is blows in winter. Yes, correct. It is blows in summer. Tell me the spelling of summer. S-U-M-M-E-R. Summer. Okay, children. Now, next question. On Independence Day, the Prime Minister of India hoist the national flag from where? They hoist the national flag from where? It is they hoist. Yes, from Red Fort. What is the spelling of Red Fort? R-E-D, Red, F-O-R-T, Fort. Understood, children? Yes, done. Have you wrote the answer? Okay, let's repeat this question again. At the time of the Emperor Shahjahan, Delhi was called Shahjahanabad. A beautiful gardens of the Rashtrapati Bhavan are called Mughal Garden. Okay? The Amar Jawan Jyoti burns in the memory of soldiers. The loo is a hot and dry wind that blows during summer. On Independence Day, the Prime Minister of India hoists the national flag from Red Fort. Understood? Done with the question number A and question number B? Okay. Shall I erase the board? Yes. Okay. Yes, children, we'll see the next question, that is answer the following. Okay, number one, what is there in answer the following? Where is Delhi located? Yes, come on children, where is Delhi located? Come on, tell me the answer. Where it is located? Yes, who will give the answer? Yes, correct. Delhi is located on the bank of the river Yamuna. Correct. Why? It is bordered by Uttar Pradesh in the east and Haryana on the other three sides. As you know, Haryana is a neighboring state of Delhi. Okay? Now come on, next question, we'll see which are the two parts that make up Delhi. Yes, already we know that Delhi consists of how many parts? Two parts. How are they different? We have to say what are the parts of Delhi and how are they different. Yes, children, as you know, Delhi consists of two parts, that is known as Old Delhi and New Delhi. And Old Delhi was built by who? It was built and ruled by the Delhi Sultans and the Mughals. And where the New Delhi was built by the British. Understood? How they are different? Where does the President of India live? Yes, children, come on, give me the answer. It is so easy. Where does the President of India live? Yes, the President of India lives in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Okay, now next question. Mention some of the tourist attractions of Delhi. Now you have to mention some tourist attraction of Delhi. Already, as you know, we have learned in this lesson so many tourist places in Delhi where you can visit. If you are planning to visit, if you are planning for picnic to visit Delhi, you can visit so many tourist places. Okay, which are those? Can you say? Yes, the Red Fort, Jama Masjid, the Qutub Minar, India Gate, Rajghat, and in many more places, many more tourist attractions are there in Delhi. You have to write some of the tourist attraction, 6 to 7, okay? Not more than that. Now next question, we'll see number 5. What kind of climate does Delhi have? Yes, children, even we have discussed about climate also. Now tell me, what kind of climate does Delhi have? Yes, give the answer. Yes, Delhi has an extreme climate. Yes, it is very hot in summer and very cold in winter. A hot dry wind called loo. When the loo blows during the summer month and it rains during the monsoon months. In which month? That is July, August and September. Okay, children, understood? What are the kinds of climate does Delhi have? It has having extreme climate. Okay, What kinds of clothes do the people of Delhi wear? Yes, even we have discussed about clothes also. Come on children, tell me what type of clothes the people they are wearing in Delhi. Yes, give me the answer. Correct. People from all states of India lives in Delhi. As you know, there are people from all states of India, they live in Delhi. So you can see people wearing all kinds of clothes in Delhi. That you can see most of the men in Delhi wear trousers and shirts. Even most women wear sari or salwar kameez. Like in other modern cities of the world, women and girls can be also seen wearing a trouser and skirts too. Yes, children? Understood? And now let's see the next question. What is this? Multiple choice question. Okay, children? Number one. Delhi was built by the Mughals, Pandavas, British. Yes, New Delhi, sorry. New Delhi was built by the Mughals, A1, P Pandavas and C British. Who has built the New Delhi? Come on children, give me the answer. Yes, correct. New Delhi was built by the British. That's why the correct answer is C. And Old Delhi was built by Mughals. The Prime Minister office is in the... Where is the Prime Minister office is in the... A1 Parliament House, B1 South Block and C1 Red Fort. Where it is? Yes, in which side? Of course, in the South Block. Okay? Correct answer is what? South Blocks. Okay? And where the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha meeting conducted, session conducted? In the Parliament House. Okay? Number three, the government of other countries have their offices in Delhi that are known. Yes, other countries that are known as A1 embassies, B1 ambassadors or C1 commissioners. Yes, of course, the answer is embassies. Okay, that is option A. Number four, Shantivan is the samadhi of... Shantivan is the samadhi of A. Mahatma Gandhi, B. Jawaharlal Nehru, C. Indira Gandhi. Yes, Shantivan is the samadhi of whom? Yes, Jawaharlal Nehru. And Mahatma Gandhi samadhi is in where? It is in Rajghat. Okay, understood? Have you solved this question, multiple choice question? Okay. Next question we'll see. Okay, till that time I will use this answer. Okay. Now let's see the next question. What is the next question? That is HOTS, HOTS. That is, you are going to think and you are going to give me the answer. Okay, children. Now tell me, why is Delhi called Mini India? Yes, come on children, you have to think and give me the answer. Why Delhi is called Mini India? Yes, because already we have learned so many things in Delhi. Yes, give on, give me, think and give me the answer. Okay, yes, Delhi is called Mini India because people from all parts of India come to live and work in Delhi. As you know, why we are calling India? Because all of the people from all parts of India, they come and they live in Delhi and work in Delhi. And all major festivals are also celebrated here. Why the all major festivals are celebrated here? Because Delhi is known as Mini India. Because all people from all parts of the state, country, people, all part of India, people come and live in Delhi. That's why we are celebrating all function, all festivals of India. That's why Delhi is known as Mini Delhi. Understood, children? Now let's see the next one. Okay. Yes, children. Come on, see, turn the page. Okay, let's see some enrichment activity. Okay, children? Let's see some enrichment activity. Okay. What we'll see in enrichment activity? First is one, speak out. Imagine you are the Prime Minister of India. Yes, you have to imagine that you are the Prime Minister of India. You have to address the nation on the occasion of Independence Day, and you have to prepare a 5-minute speech and say it in front of your class. As you know children, due to COVID-19 we are not in school, that's why we are conducting online classes. But you can, what you can do, if you are not supposed to say in front of your class, you can say in front of your family member. What you are going to do, you are going to imagine yourself that you are a Prime Minister of India and you are going to address the nation on which occasion? On the occasion of Independence Day. And you are going to prepare a 5-minute speech, yes? And you are going to say in front of your family, but it is there in front of your class, because we are not coming to school, that's why you have to say in front of your family. You have to prepare a speech about 5 minutes, okay? Now next is what? Get creative. Now what you are going to do, which creative work you are going to do? You are going to design and create a poster titled Delhi, Mini Delhi. You can design by your own and you have to create a poster and you have to give the title name. What you are going to give the title name? Delhi, Mini India. Why it is Mini India? Why it is called a Mini India? You have to create that Delhi is known as Mini India. Why it is known as Mini India? Why the people from other states are coming and living and working in Delhi? That's why Delhi is known as Mini India. You can see so many festivals we are celebrating in India. So many festivals we are celebrating in Delhi. That's why you have to create your own design and you have to create a poster and you have to give the name of, what you are going to give the name, title name, what will be the title name? Delhi, the Mini India. Okay, next see, find out more about Delhi from the internet. As you have learned in the Delhi, what are the ancient monuments, so many tourist places, who has built old Delhi, new Delhi, what are the government's offices are there, already we have learned. If you want to find about more about Delhi, you can search from the internet, okay? Now what you are going to do, you are going to do some project work. You are going to research and then write 10 sentences in your scrapbook. You are going to research by yourself and you are going to write a 10 sentences in your scrapbook. What you are going to write 10 sentences in your scrapbook? About your own city where you are staying, okay? Or a city focusing on the following excerpts, okay? What you are going to write in this? Your location of your city, the language spoken, and what is the climate, the main festivals, which festivals are celebrated in your town or your city, and the food, which food is famous, and the places of interesting places where you can visit. Like as you have learned in the Delhi part, you can visit so many tourist attractions. You can see Red Fort, Lal Killa, Jama Masjid. Yes, so many workshops also you can visit. Akshardham Temple, Jama Masjid. Yes. So many tourist attraction. In the same way, you're in your city, in your town, you are having the places where you can visit more, and where is the location, where it is located, and what type of language in your cities they have spoken, and what climate is there in your city, and what are the main festivals, which festivals are celebrated, and what is the famous food. You have to write the 10 sentence with the help of these points, okay? As you have seen, A to F, and you are going to write 10 sentences in your scrapbook, okay? Now let's see the next one, that is hands-on. Working in group, do a project on the Commonwealth Games held in Delhi in 2010. Focus on the following points. As you know, this is a working group. Means this project you have to do in a group. But we are not in school because of this COVID-19. So I will explain you this, the project Commonwealth Games held in Delhi in 2010. And you have to focus this point, following points. But we are not supposed to do this activity, okay? Let's see this activity. What you are going to focus on, which point you might have focused. the number of sports played. Yes, the number of sports played. How many numbers of sports it has played? The number of countries that participate. Medals won by India. The mascot of the game. The opening and the closing ceremonies. Even we have discussed so many points in this activity, this project, but because of this we are going to skip this activity. Okay, next, see about life skill and values. Okay, civic awareness, protecting our monuments. Okay, people like writing their names and drawing pictures on the wall of our old and beautiful monuments. Yes, people like to write the names and even can draw the pictures on the walls of your old and beautiful monuments. Have you seen people doing this? Okay, writing on the monument is an offense against society. Is it good? If you are visiting any tourist attraction, any beautiful monuments, if you are visiting, you are supposed to write your name and you are supposed to draw the picture on the wall. Is it a good way? Is it a good manner? No, that is very bad. You are not supposed to write on these beautiful monuments. You are not supposed to write their name, your name, and you are not supposed to drawing a picture. That is very bad thing. That's why whenever you visit a grave, means beautiful monuments, you have to see, and you are not supposed to write the names and you are not supposed to draw the picture on it. Okay, writing on, what will happen if you write the names on, or even you will draw the picture, what will happen? Writing on monuments is the offense against society, because it is offense against society. We should take pride in our monuments. We have to take our own pride that our monument, it is our duty to maintain them. What is our duty? To maintain them. Which of these you will do? Preserve your monuments. What take care you will do to preserve our monuments, your monuments? Not first one, scribble on the walls of the monuments. Are you going to scribble on the walls of the monuments? You are going to scribble? No, very good. You are not going to scribble. Number two, pick up litter from around the monuments. Yes, you are going to pick up litter from around the monuments. Of course, wherever you can find something has litter around the monument, you are going to pick up those. That is a good habit. Very good, children. Touch the engravings on the walls of the monuments. No. Run around the play inside the monument. You are going to run around and play the inside the monument. Yes, but you have to avoid to do this thing. Okay, and even ask people not to spit inside the monument. Of course, it is a bad manner if the people not to spit inside the monument. Of course, we are not supposed to spit inside the monument. It is a good manner. If you find this person who is spitting, you have to tell them not to do this thing in the monument. Sixth one, ask people not to stick poster on the walls of the monument. If you find that a person or a person who is sticking the poster, then you are going to tell them you are not supposed to stick the poster on the walls of the monuments. Okay, children, understood? Yes, children. Here, what we have seen? Life skills and values. Okay. Now, yes, children. In the next session. Already what we have seen in this today's session, we have solved some textbook exercise and we have seen enrichment activity. As you know, we have completed our lesson number 5. And in the next session, what we are going to do? In the next session, we are going to start with the new lesson, that is lesson number 6. Now what we have learned in lesson number 5, where we have learned? Delhi. We have visited what are the Asian monuments in Delhi, where the local government offices are located, what are the climates, cloths. Yes, we have seen in this lesson. Now in the next session, we are going to start with the new lesson, that is lesson number 6. We are going to see in the next session about lesson number 6, Mumbai. Till that time, what you are going to do? You are going to read this lesson number 5 once again. If you have not learned hard words, again and again I am telling that you have to learn hard words. If you have not learned the hard words, you have to learn those hard words again. Okay, and you have to read this lesson once again. Till that time, thank you. Bye-bye.